I'm so excited to see you again. I don't know if you remember this, but the last time I saw KIESZA was at TIFF 2016. I was a fan of yours because we were playing your music on the radio and I had interviewed you before, and then I was hanging out with you, and then suddenly something just happened and you kind of just disappeared, and I was wondering, well, what happened to her? And you got severely injured and hit by a vehicle. So can we just start by that and talk about your
Toronto. I moved to Toronto. Yeah, I moved to Toronto. I was all excited because my brothers live there, and I had been traveling so much that I hadn't seen my family very much. One day I was just in an Uber, literally I was planning on going to dinner with somebody, and then a cab ran a red light in an intersection and T-boned my Uber, and I sustained a really, really bad traumatic brain injury. It ended up being almost a 3-year recovery, and I'm still actually recovering, if you can believe it. But they take time.
Well, I mean, you look amazing. I saw your video. I was listening to your music, and I'm like, yay, she's back. And it's such a feel-good vibe. So why is 2020 marking of a rebirth for you?
Oh, I mean, I've become a whole different person in a good way. I've grown so much just by having to endure what I did, and deciding to rebuild myself as an independent artist, and the time that's gone by, and just the things I've been through, and the time I've even had to reflect on my life by being removed from everything, it's just really transformed me, and I feel like I'm coming back a whole new person. But yeah, I've just been working on the new album, and honestly, I've had a lot of time to work on the albums to follow. So
that's great. So love you. Love the content. Tell me about your road to writing and what this album is going to say that your other albums didn't.
This album is actually kind of like the tip of the iceberg to get people ready for what's to come. And finally feeling kind of like my old self in many ways. And so I wanted this album to be really positive, upbeat, high energy. It's retro. It has an 80s flair, definitely a modern twist, but it's positive through and through. Like, it's, you can kind of put it on and get into a mood for the whole thing.
So I was looking at your past experience, you know, like when you look at someone's profile, you know, if you were single, for example, and you would be on a dating site, it would say Royal Canadian Navy sniper, ballet dancer, beauty queen, singer-songwriter, has written for Rihanna, Jennifer Hudson, worked with Duran Duran, collaborated with Pitbull, and is a Juno Award winner. What's on your to-do list, aside from releasing this incredible album in 2020, what are other things that you want to do? Acting?
I've been asked to act a lot. So it's funny because like I haven't been chasing it down, but I think I'd actually do really well because I feel very comfortable in front of the camera.
So for anybody who I guess is having some hard days during COVID, and because you seem to have kind of mastered using your time efficiently, and using your time during quarantine to kind of make a difference in your life and in others, what advice would you give them?
My advice to everyone is take advantage of the fact that this time gives people both time and space that they normally, I don't think, have or don't give themselves, especially because they're glued to their phone, they're out just trying to make a living, and anything you want to work on it now because we don't know how long this will last. And obviously I want things to open up again. I miss people and socializing, but while it's here, we might as well take advantage of that.
Right. Well, this interview made me really happy, and seeing your face and being back on the
show. Well, hopefully I'll see you in Toronto. I'm working on a whole EP out there, which is really exciting. Okay. Yeah.
I'll be there. And hopefully I can be able to give you a hug. And
I know. Don't you miss hugs? Like,
totally miss hugs.
Canadians are such huggers too. It's funny. Like, I always used to hug people and they're like, go to shake my hand. I'm like, oh, that's awkward. I'm going to hug you. I was like, Canadians like the hug. What can I say?
we give the two cheek kiss here in Montreal. So it's really been awkward. Yeah. There you go.
I love that. It's so European.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Okay. Well, take care.